TPO wall flashings without rust. Mechanical or base attachment is required at all angle changes of 2 inches per foot or greater. On standard TPO membranes, when not using 6-inch RUSS, 2.4-inch seam plates and heavy-duty fasteners, or all-purpose bar and heavy-duty fasteners, can be used. We will use plates and fasteners in this demonstration. Install the field sheet so that it extends all the way to the base of the wall. It should not run up the wall. Attach or adhere the membrane to the field of the roof. Install 2.4-inch seam plates and number 14 HD or number 15 EHD fasteners along the base of the wall at the same spacing as the field sheets. Try to keep the plates within half inch from the wall. Measure the wall at the outermost plate to determine the required flashing height. The flashings must extend a minimum of 8 inches above the roof surface and be terminated, or be long enough to extend over the top and down the face of the parapet. Extend the flashing onto the roof a minimum of 6 inches and at least 2 inches past the outside plate. Extending the flashing 6 inches onto the deck will allow the use of an automatic welder to complete the seams. Crease the membrane at the angle change location using a 2-inch roller. Creasing the membrane at this transition will help prevent bridging. Do not use heat to create the crease. Apply an approved adhesive to both the substrate and back of the membrane. Do not apply adhesive in any seam areas. The following adhesives are approved for use on vertical applications for standard TPO membranes: TPO bonding adhesive, AeroWeb low VOC aerosol contact adhesive, low VOC bonding adhesive, low VOC 1168 bonding adhesive, and AquaBase 120 bonding adhesive. We are using AquaBase 120 in this demonstration. Let adhesive dry until tacky. It should be tacky but not string to a dry finger. Snap a reference line on the flashing sheet to help set the sheet. Set the reference line to the point on the wall and carefully set the flashings into the adhesive. Once adhered, broom or roll the wall to ensure full adhesion. Weld the seams. Allow to cool, then probe for voids and repair all voids. Things to remember: base attachments must be installed at all angle changes of 2 inches per foot or greater. The flashing should extend onto the roof surface a minimum of 6 inches and be at least 2 inches past the outside plate. Do not cover weep holes or through wall counter flashings. All flashings must be terminated following Mule-Hide's published details.